Investors and financial institutions around the world have long relied on credit rating agencies to assess risk. Those very agencies are blamed in part for the financial crisis after failing to report the true risks of subprime mortgages. The European Parliament has approved legislation aimed at restoring confidence in those credit rating agencies and in turn stability in the financial markets.
A leading force behind the reform is Jean-Paul Gauzès, the EPP Group's coordinator on the Parliament's Economic and Monetary Affairs Committee. He says the legislation, to take effect in 2015, is aimed at ensuring credit ratings agencies play a positive role in the economy. And he says the legislation has already had a positive effect.
I think we can constate that the agencies have made efforts to adapt to the new regulation, that the train mass that was announced has not created the catastrophe, and that we have a certain... qui est une meilleure quiétude sur les marchés financiers, mais les réformes sont suffisamment récentes, notamment sur les dettes souveraines, pour qu'on ne puisse pas en tirer encore toutes les conclusions. Mais je crois qu'on peut être optimiste.
Gauzès worked closely with EU Commissioner Michel Barnier, also a member of the EPP.
Ah oui, il y a un très grand changement pour ces agences de notation. Et les agences font partie de ce paysage qui doit être mieux régulé et correctement supervisé. Donc je veux dire que ce n'est pas le thermomètre qui crée la fièvre, mais en revanche, le thermomètre doit fonctionner correctement. Il ne doit pas aggraver, il ne doit pas accentuer la fièvre, ce qui a été quelquefois le cas, on l'a vu avec certaines agences de notation.
A number of struggling EU governments have suffered from credit ratings they say unfairly raised their borrowing costs. The legislation sets a calendar limiting unsolicited ratings of sovereign debt to 3 a year. The rules affect agencies including the U.S.-based majors Fitch, Standard & Poor's and Moody's, which drew criticism during the financial crisis.
La volonté en mettant en place ce dispositif, c'était d'éviter qu'il n'y ait des notations intempestives à des moments anormaux, alors que ces notes sont légitimes, à condition qu'elles ne viennent pas perturber plus que raisonnablement les marchés, notamment les marchés financiers. Par exemple, sortir une note non annoncée, non sollicitée, la veille d'une réunion de l'ECOFIN qui va mettre en difficulté telle ou telle décision que prendraient les ministres.
The European Banking Federation has been generally supportive of the new rules.
I think the very positive aspect of it is that it has been firmly put in a regulatory sphere. I think also the ESMA supervision, the sort of European Security Markets Authority, to have an oversight in terms of how are the governance arrangements inside the rating agencies that are acceptable to offer their opinions in the European Union. That I think has beneficial effect. It's also some first step towards a more singular supervisory approach.
Ratings agencies have been accused of competing for ratings contracts by making favorable ratings of certain bundled investments that included subprime mortgages. Some agencies have been accused of conflict of interest, coloring their ratings reports, helping set off the subprime financial crisis.
One element that is also very useful and helpful is to try and diminish the over-reliance on credit ratings. That was certainly something I think that with the heady days of the pre-crisis, people were forgetting to do their own homework. And I think this is an important part of the refocus by the Parliament and the Council as co-legislator to really make it clear to everybody that you can't just take a rating and act on the back of that.
Gauzès says the reform, which is to take effect in 2015, aims to combat conflict of interest by limiting cross-investments.
Il y a des risques de conflits d'intérêts auxquels il faut apporter remède.
European bankers back the idea, but are not certain of the impact.
The proposals to eliminate conflict of interest rules within the credit rating agencies are sensible, but again, in practice, not that straightforward to implement, so we'll have to see what that leads to.
The reform calls for establishment of a European credit ratings agency, though both Gauzès and Pristo say it could be a long way off.
If the liability requirements and the obligations resting on rating agencies are now so strict or heavy, as a new market entrant, as a new proposition to do that, the appetite is just not there in a, shall we say, private market context.
The legislation adds teeth to the reform by increasing civil liability for ratings agencies, allowing those negatively affected to sue for damages.
Celui qui se plaint d'un grief à l'égard d'une agence doit indiquer clairement quel est le grief qu'il invoque, quelle est la réglementation qui aurait été violée, et c'est alors à l'agence de prouver qu'elle a fait le nécessaire pour être en conformité avec la réglementation. Je prends un exemple concret. Une note est mauvaise, entre guillemets. Un investisseur se plaint en disant « si cette note n'était pas exacte, n'était pas bonne, c'est parce que vous employez un personnel qui n'est pas qualifié. » L'agence devra prouver qu'elle a recruté du personnel qui remplissait les conditions professionnelles nécessaires.
The reform doesn't mean the pressure's off governments to be fiscally responsible. Credit ratings will remain an early warning system.
That is a market discipline that will indeed apply and that will help sovereigns and governments to run a tidy ship.
Le vrai problème de ces notations, c'est pas qu'elles existent. On a besoin d'évaluer les risques. C'est une vieille histoire que d'évaluer les risques et de prendre une bonne décision d'investissement en ayant le meilleur jugement sur le risque qu'on prend. Il faut simplement que la notation soit correcte, qu'elle tombe au bon moment, qu'elle ne soit pas non plus obligatoire dans tous les domaines.
It's difficult to estimate the damage from credit rating agencies in the financial crisis. There's plenty of blame to go around. But the European Parliament has taken action aimed at ensuring that risk assessment does not compound the hardship in economies struggling to recover. Find out more about the activities of the largest political force in Parliament by checking eppgroup.eu. Thanks for watching, and see you again soon.